We continue now at the top of Daf Mem Tes Amud Aleph from Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 49a. The Mishnah says, Arba Asar Shechol Lios B'Shabbos. Let's say the 14th of Nisan falls out on Shabbos. You have a potential problem here because it's going to be difficult to destroy the chametz on Shabbos on the 14th. Mevaren is Hakol Milifnei HaShabbos Divrei Rabbi Meir. According to Rabbi Meir, everything needs to be destroyed before Shabbos. Doesn't matter whether it's chulin, doesn't matter whether it's truma. Just leave over that which you will eat on Shabbos, that chametz which you will eat on Shabbos. All the rest, destroy before Shabbos. B'chachomim omrim b'zman, when the chachomim say no, you can destroy it all on Shabbos itself, on the 14th. Rabbi Eliezer bar Tzadok omer, Rabbi Eliezer bar Tzadok says, truma milifnei haShabbos. When it comes to truma, there's not a lot of people available to eat truma. That you should destroy before Shabbos, because it's really impossible to eat it all on Shabbos itself. B'chulin b'zman and b'chulin, you can always find people who can eat the chulin, so you can keep it for Shabbos, and then anything that's left over, as Pesach is coming, you can always destroy it on Shabbos itself, or be mevatel it on Shabbos itself. The Gemara says, Tanya, we learned in a Braiser, Rabbi Elazar bar Tzadok Omer, Rabbi Elazar bar Tzadok says, that's the same Rabbi Elazar bar Tzadok in our Mishnah. Pamachas shavas abba b'yavne, one time, Abba spent Shabbos in Yavne, v'chol arbo osr lios b'shabbos, and the 14th of Nisan came out on Shabbos that time. Uvaz Zonin Mimuna shel Rabbi Gamliel, and Zonin, who was the appointee of Rabbi Gamliel, came. V'yomar, and he said, Higia eis lebaris hachometz. The time now has come on Shabbos to destroy the chometz. V'alachti achar Abba, I went after Abba. Uviyarnu es hachometz, and we destroyed the chometz. That is brought as a proof to Rabbi Elazar bar Tzadok's opinion that other than Shruma, you can destroy everything on the 14th on Shabbos itself. And the Mishnah says, Aholech lishchot es pischo, let's say somebody's going in order to shech this Karban Pesach on the 14th of Nisan, v'lomol es b'no, he's going to do bris milo, v'lechol su'udas erisin v'veis chomav, or he's going to eat the su'udas erisin, the meal of engagement by the house of his father-in-law. All of these things are things of mitzvah. V'nizkar sheyesh lo chametz b'soch beso. Then, as he's going to do these mitzvahs, he remembers he's got some chametz in his house. So, im yachol lachzor ulevar v'lachzor l'mitzvaso. If he's able to go back, destroy the chametz, and get back to his mitzvah, yachzor v'yavar, then he should go back and physically destroy the chametz. V'im lav, if not, if he's going to miss out on the mitzvah, better to do mevatlo belibo, better that he just be mevatel, that he should just nullify the chametz in his heart, and then he'll continue on and do his mitzvah. However, the Mishnah says, lahatzel min hanochrim, min hanor, min halistim, min hadleko, min hamapolis. Let's say he's going for something, not just a mitzvah, he's going to save Jews who are running away from non-Jews, he's saving them from a river, from robbers, from a fire, from a collapsed building. In that case, it doesn't matter if he has time or not. Yevatel belibo, he should always just be mevatel it in his heart. He shouldn't go back because this is a situation of danger, and he should make sure to take care of it. And the Mishnah says, "Velishbos shavisas harashus." Let's say what he's doing is just something optional, voluntary. In this case, he's going to travel in order to set up a makom shvisa to extend his tchum, not for a mitzvah purpose. He's extending his tchum for some voluntary purpose, something that he wants to do. So in that case, there's no mitzvah involved whatsoever. Yachzer miyad, he should return immediately to physically destroy the chametz. Something that is just a rashus, that's not a mitzvah, you're not allowed to just do bittel. You have to physically destroy the chametz. And the Mishnah says, v'chein, similarly, misha yotzam Yerushalayim v'nizkar sheyesh biyado b'sar kodesh. Let's say somebody leaves Yerushalayim, and he remembers that he's carrying with him meat of hektish. And the halach is, once it leaves the walls of Yerushalayim, it leaves that area, so it's outside of the area where Kachim Kalim is supposed to be. Now you have a problem, you're really supposed to burn it near the Beis HaMikdash. So the Mishnah says, im'avar tzufim, if he passed the location, the village of Tzufim. Now, the village of Tzufim was a place where you could still see the Beis HaMikdash. So if you pass that, you're already far from the Beis HaMikdash. Sarfo b'mekomo, he should just burn the hektish meat wherever he is. V'im lav, but if he did not pass Tzufim, chozer v'tzarfo, he should return, go back to the area of the Beis HaMikdash, and burn it over there, lefnei habira, in front of the bira, me'atzeh hamarocha, from the wood of the Mizbeach. He should use the actual wood of the Mizbeach by the Beis HaMikdash in order to burn this meat. V'arkama hein choser. Now, for how much, regarding both chametz and meat, how much chametz do you have to go back and physically take care of it? Rabbi Meir omer zev zev bekebeitza. Rabbi Meir says the amount is always a kebeitza, less than a kebeitza, so by chametz just do bittel, by besar kodesh just burn it where you are, you don't have to physically return. Rabbi Yehuda omer, Rabbi Yehuda says zev zev bekezayis. By both of them, not a kebeitza, even if it's just a kezayis, which is smaller, that's enough to obligate you again to physically destroy the chametz or to return back to the Beis HaMikdash in order to burn the Besar Hekdash. V'chachamim omrim, and the Chachamim say, we make a distinction, Besar Kodesh b'kazayis, when it comes to meat of Hekdash, that you have to return even if it's a kazayis. V'chametz b'kabetza, but when it comes to chametz, so there it already has to be a kabetza. If it's less than a kabetza, you don't have to return to physically destroy it. So the Gemara asks, or a minute we have a contradiction. Aholech lechol sudas erisin v'veis chamav. Let's say somebody's going to eat again a sudas erisin, a meal to celebrate the engagement at the house of his father-in-law, velishbos shvisas harashus, or to create a makom shvisa to extend his tchum, not for mitzvah purposes, yachzer miyad. So those are both not considered mitzvahs, and he has to return immediately in order to take care of the chametz. So here in this brisa, it contradicts the Mishnah. The brisa is implying that a sudas erisin is just a rishus. It's not a mitzvah. Our Mishnah said it's a mitzvah. So the Gemara answers, Amar Rav Yochanan, and Rav Yochanan says, Lokash is not difficult. Har Rav Yehuda, Har Rav Yossi. It's a machlokas Rav Yehuda and Rav Yossi. The Tanya will learn a brisa, Sudas Erison, when it comes to the Sudas Erison, Rishus Divrei Rav Yehuda. According to Rav Yehuda, that's just a rishus. It's not a mitzvah. Rav Yossi, Omer Mitzvah, Rav Yossi says it's a mitzvah. But the Gemara says, Vahashto Damar Rav Chista. But now that Rav Chista said, Machlokas Besuuda Shnia, the whole machlokas Rav Yossi and Rav Yehuda is only by the second meal. They used to have a second meal of celebration when the chasen would give some gifts to the kala. There's a machlokas whether it's a mitzvah or not. Avo besuda rishona divrei akol mitzvah. But when it comes to the first meal that they celebrated, everybody agrees it's a mitzvah. So afilu teimo havar Rav Yehuda. According to Rav Chista, you can even say the Braisa and the Mishnah, they both follow Rav Yehuda. V'lo kash, it's not difficult. Ha besuda rishona, ha besuda shnia. In the case we're saying it's a mitzvah, in our Mishnah, that's the first meal, and the Braisa, which says it's not a mitzvah, is talking about the second meal. Tanya, we learned in a Braisa, Rabbi Yehuda says, Ani lo shamati el sudas erisin. I only heard it's a mitzvah, the original sudas erisin, avalosiv lonos, not that second meal where they send the gifts. Amar lo Rabbi Yossi, Rabbi Yossi said to him, Ani shamati sudas erisin visiv lonos. I heard, that it's even the original Sudas Erisin and the second Suda that they do the gifts. That's also a Mishnah that is the same as we just said. That's the same as Rav Chista just explained, that the Machlokas, Rav Yehuda and Rav Yossi, is by the Suda Shnia, by the second Suda. Tanya, we learned in a Braisa, Rav Yishim and Omer, Rav Yishim says, Kol Suda She'ena Shal Mitzvah, any meal that is not a meal of a mitzvah, Ein Talmud Chacham Rashoi Lehonos Mimena. A Talmud Chacham is not permitted to derive benefit from such a meal. To go in my, the Gemara says, what's an example? What are you talking about? What kind of meal is a meal that is not a mitzvah? Amar Rav Yochanan, and Rav Yochanan says, Kagon, bas kohen li Yisrael. Let's say the daughter of a kohen marries Yisrael. That's not a good thing. A daughter of a kohen should really marry into kohanim. Uvas talmud chacham la'am haaretz. Or if you have the daughter of a talmud chacham marrying an am haaretz, also it's problematic. That's considered a su'uda that's not a mitzvah. A talmud chacham should not benefit from such a su'uda. The Amar Rav Yochanan, because Rav Yochanan says, bas kohen li Yisrael, when it comes to a daughter of a kohen marrying a Yisrael, ein zivugan ola yafa. That pairing is not going to come out good. It's not going to be, as Rashi says, with a mazel tov. Maihi, so the Gemara says, what does it mean? What's going to happen in such a situation? Amar Rav Chista, Rav Chista says, o almana, either it's going to end, the person's going to be a widow, o gerusha, or divorce, o zera ein la, or she will not have children, Rashi over here says, O almana, o grusha, o zera ein la kedichsiv, like it says, uvas kohen ki siya le'ish zar. Pasuk says, a bas kohen marries an ish zar. V'samuch le'u bas kohen ki siya almana, grusha, v'zera ein la. There's a pasuk nearby that talks about a bas kohen who's an almana, grusha, zera ein la. So it's a drusha that such a marriage to an ish zar is going to cause these things to happen. V'masnizatana, we saw in the braisa, kovra, o kovraso, O meviyasuli de anios. Either it's going to cause that she's going to be buried early, he's going to be buried early, or it's going to bring him to poverty. One of these bad things will happen with such a marriage. Gemara says, Ini, is this really true? Is it really such a problem when you have a bas kohen marrying Yisrael? V'yamar Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yochanan said, and it's the very same Rabbi Yochanan, Harotza sheyisasher, if somebody wants to become wealthy, Yidbek bizaro shel Aaron, he should attach himself to the children of Aaron, Kol shekein shetorah kohuna me'asharton, because certainly then what's going to happen is the Torah and the kohuna will combine and make the person very wealthy. So on the contrary, it seems to be a good thing to marry into the daughter of a kohen. So the Gemara says lo kasha, it's not difficult. Ha b'talmud chacham, ha b'amaretz. It depends if the person is a talmud chacham or an amaretz. And Rashi over here says talmud chacham hu shevach lo. That's already a praise. It's good for him to marry a bas kohen. Avolam Oretz Veino Kohen, but if a person's not a Kohen, And he's also an Amoretz, Genayu lo, Liaron, Vinen Nashim. It's already a disgrace to Aaron that his children will marry into this situation, and then there's going to be punishment. And the Gemara continues, Rabbi Yoshua, Nasiv Kahanta, Rabbi Yoshua married the daughter of a Kohen Chola, she became weak, he became ill. Amar, he said, Lo nichole Liaron, Dadvik Bezare, Dahavale Chasno Kiano. It's not good for Aaron that his children should marry a son-in-law like me. Obviously, it was a bad thing that I married the daughter of a Kohen. Ravidi Baravin Nasiv Kanta. On the other hand, the Gemara is another story. Ravidi Baravin married the daughter of a Kohen. Nafku Minei Tre Bani Smichi, two sons who were ordained came out of that marriage. Rav Sheshes Bereid Ravidi, Rav Yoshua Bereid Ravidi. The two sons were Rav Sheshes, the son of Ravidi, and Rav Yoshua, the son of Ravidi. Amar Papa, Rav Papa says, Ilo Nisivna Kahanta Lo Yasri. Had I not married the daughter of a Kohen, I would not have become wealthy. Amar Rav Kahana, Rav Kahana said, Ilo Nisivna Kahanta. Had I not married the daughter of a Kohen, Lo Galoi, I would not have went into exile. So it was a negative for me. Amrulei, they said to him, what are you talking about? V'holamakam Torah Galisa. You were exiled to an area of Torah. It wasn't so bad what happened to you, Rav Kahana. So you shouldn't complain that had you not married the daughter of a Kohen, this wouldn't have happened. So he answered, Lo galoi kedugaliin shino, but I wouldn't have been exiled like the regular, normal people get exiled. In other words, other Talmidim who came here, they did it willingly, but I was exiled by force because of the fear of the government, so that would not have happened to me if not for the fact that I married the daughter of a Kohen. Amar Rabbi Yitzchak says, Kol hanen misudas harashus. Anybody who is nen, anybody who benefits from a sudas harashus, lasov gola, in the end, he's going to be exiled. Shenemar, like the pasuk says, v'ochlim karem mitzon v'agolim mitoch marbek, talking about, again, eating of the meat, uchsiv, and it says, lochein ata yiglu b'rosh golem. You will be exiled at the head of the exiles. The Gemara continues at the two dots, Tanu Rabbanu, we learned in a braisa, kol talmid chacham hamarbe su'udasu b'chol mokom, any talmid chacham who has meals, he eats a lot of meals in all places, meaning he participates in too many celebrations. Sof machrev espeso, in the end, his house will be destroyed. Umalmon esishto, his wife will become a widow. Umiasem eskozolov, his children will become orphans. Betalmudo mishtakach mimenu, his learning will be forgotten from him. Umachlukos rabos bozolov, there's going to be many arguments because of the fact that he forgot his learning. There's going to be many, many arguments that surround him. Udvorav einam nishma, and people are not going to listen to him. Umachalol shem shamayim, he's going to cause a chil Hashem. V'shem rabo v'shem aviv, he's going to disgrace the name of his Rebbe, the name of his father. V'gorim shem ra lo ulevonov, v'levnei vonov atzov kol adoros. He causes there to be a bad name for him, for his sons, and for his sons' sons, until the end of all generations. All of this is going to happen because he participated too much in too much eating of these meals, participating in these meals. Gemara says, Mahi, what is this bad name that's going to happen to his children? Amar Abaya says, Karule bar mechem tanure. They'll call the children the sons of the one who heats up the ovens. He's always participating again in these meals. Rava says, bar market bekuvi. He's the guy, this is the children of those who dance in the stores. They're always drunk, they're always dancing around. Rav Papa says, bar malachich pinchi, the son, the child of the one who's always licking the bowls, again, eating too much. Rav Shmaya says, bar machreva, Rashi says, machreva mekafe levusho verovitz v'yoshen. He folds his garment, he crouches, and he goes to sleep. Kach derech ha-mishtakrin. Again, that's what happens to those who are drunk, eino maspik, leilech levesu, l'shachiv al-mitah, so they don't have enough time. They're not able to go home and sleep on their bed. Ela mekafe levusho tachta v'yoshen. He just sleeps under his own garment. These are all disgraceful terminologies that are going to be used about this person's children. And the Gemara continues at the two dots. Tanu Rabbanu, we learned in a braisa. Liolam yimchor adam kol ma sheyesh lo v'yisa bas talmid chacham. A person should sell everything he has in order that he should marry the daughter of a talmid chacham. Shemei so gola, because if the person should die or if the person will be exiled, muftach lo, in such a situation, he marries the daughter of a talmid chacham, will be guaranteed shebon of talmid chacham, that his children will also be talmid chachamim. V'al yisa bas am haaretz, and the person should not marry the daughter of an am haaretz. Shemei so gola, if he dies or he's exiled, bon of am haaretz, his children will be am haaretzim. Tanu Rabbanu, we learned in a braisa, liolam yimchor adam kol ma sheyesh lo, a person should sell everything that he has, v'yisa bas talmid chacham, and he should marry the daughter of a talmid chacham, v'yasi bitul a talmid chacham, and he should marry off his own daughter to a talmid chacham, mashal lin ve'agefen bin ve'agefen. It's similar when you have the vines they wrap themselves around similar vines. They're intertwined with vines like them. Dover no miskabel, that's something nice. That's something that's received properly. The lo yisabas amoretz, the person should not marry the daughter of an amoretz. Masha linve hagefen bin veasnet, that would be comparable to the vines of a gefen intermingling with the vines of a sneh, with the vines of just a bush, a bramble, dover kar, that's something that's not nice. And we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Mem Tes Amud Beis.